of despair in the lives of thousands of sightless men and women as a result of several projects in which books and maps have been translated into Braille, the written language of the blind. The proofreading of these works is done by sightless experts. In some cities, instruction is given in the reading of Braille maps. The tragedy of blindness has been the lot of thousands of our people in regions where trachoma, a dread eye disease, is prevalent. Many of its victims are prevented by poverty, isolation, or infirmity from receiving medical attention. To these people come visiting nurses to examine suspected cases, and provision has been made for transportation to free clinics. With this assistance, medical science has found it possible to control a disease which is a menace to young and old alike, in many cases affecting every member of a large family. Needless to say, the staff necessary to maintain this important service is recruited from the trained workers of the regions concerned. And again, useful employment is combined with an enterprise of great and immediate value to the community. Everyone is familiar with the fine work being done by the famous Warm Springs Foundation in the cure of children crippled by infantile paralysis. To thousands who would otherwise be hopeless cripples for the rest of their lives has been given the chance to overcome their handicaps. Much of the success of the treatment given at Warm Springs and elsewhere depends upon the existence of therapeutic pools in which patients may gradually recover the use of their muscles through exercise made easier by the support of warm water. In many parts of the country, WPA labor has constructed pools such as these, and trained WPA workers make up the staffs which assist in the medical treatment. This therapeutic pool is in the James Whitcomb Riley Memorial Hospital in Indiana, made doubly interesting by Riley's immortal poem about the little crippled boy with curvature of the spine. In hundreds of cities, the Works program safeguards the health of many thousands of normal children of preschool age. In nursery schools, the children of needy and working mothers are provided with the best of care and medical supervision. Projects which are part of a broad educational program in which the WPA has helped millions of children and adults. Supervised play activities and preschool training under competent instructors removed from the relief roles are part of the schedule at each of these nursery schools. Meals are provided for the youngsters, and plenty of health-building milk and orange juice is consumed during the mid-morning and mid-afternoon luncheons. The food is prepared under the supervision of dietitians. And at all times, a careful check of the health and development of the children is maintained. In these nursery schools, the youngsters acquire habits which will guard their health later in life. Here is a work which lays the foundation for a new generation of good citizens.